Stanford University.
We are on our way to the Forest of Nisene Marks, which is the epicenter, the point on the Earth's surface directly above the 1989 Loma Prieta earthquake. The Loma Prieta earthquake ruptured on a fault close to, but not quite on the San Andreas Fault. The earthquake started at a depth of 16 or 17 kilometers. One of the interesting aspects of this earthquake was, despite the fact that it was large and damaging, magnitude 6.9, the rupture did not reach the Earth's surface. It didn't even get very close to the Earth's surface. During the earthquake, the fault slipped. It had a horizontal component of motion, also a vertical component of motion. The San Andreas Fault itself, we think, has just a horizontal component of motion. So this vertical component was a little bit of a surprise. As the fault slips, it generates seismic waves. Those waves propagate out in all directions, and it's those waves that manifest as the shaking that we feel in earthquakes and that cause damage. So there are a lot of things that can influence the strength of these waves, the intensity of shaking, and hence the distribution of damage. In particular, sedimentary basins have low seismic velocity, so they tend to amplify seismic waves, they tend to trap seismic waves. For example, in the Loma Prieta earthquake, in the East Bay, the Cypress structure of the Nimitz Freeway, that's where two-thirds of the fatalities in this earthquake occurred as that structure collapsed. The part that collapsed was built on loosely consolidated sediments on the periphery of the bay. The shaking, we know from aftershocks, is greatly amplified. In San Francisco, a lot of the damage downtown and in the Marina District was fill that liquefied and settled differentially and caused all kinds of problems to structures there. We know from historical records that the 19th century was extremely active. That is, leading up to the 1906 earthquake, there were decades when there were damaging earthquakes about once a year in the Bay Area. The time since the 1906 earthquake, except for the 1989 Loma Prieta earthquake, there have been relatively few earthquakes. We think that the Bay Area is likely to enter a phase where damaging earthquakes are more common in the future.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.